Hello, I'm Dave Martin, and welcome to Creo Parametric for Absolute Beginners. If you would like the files that are used in these demonstrations, go to www.creowindchill.com/dropbox, and you can download the creoabsolutebeginners.zip file and then extract it to some folder on your computer. When you do that, you'll notice that there are a bunch of files in that folder. First off, if you have a file that ends in a .prt extension, that is a Creo Parametric part file. Anything that ends in .asm is a Creo Parametric assembly, and drawings end in .drw. A drawing usually has a format associated with it, and the drawing format ends in .frm. You'll notice with these different files, they have an additional extension, which is a period followed by a number. When you create a new object in Creo Parametric, it's going to have a .1 appended on the end of the name. When you save a model, it doesn't overwrite the original file, it creates a new iteration of the file. And so that's why, for example, this drawing has a .2 on the end of the name. So again, saving creates a new iteration of the object with the number increased on the end of the name. All right, let's go ahead and launch Creo Parametric. So I'm going to locate the icon for it on my computer screen. And this demonstration applies to Creo Parametric 1.0, 2.0, and 3.0. In Creo Parametric 4.0, the selection algorithm changed. So that's going to be a different set of videos. So Creo Parametric has opened on the computer screen. There is a resource window that's open, but I'm just gonna close it. Now, the next step is optional, but I prefer to do it, and it's called selecting the working directory. The working directory is how you tell Creo Parametric what folder that you want to open files from and save them to. So it's a bit of a time saver to set that up at the beginning. So I'm going to work out of my Creo Absolute Beginners folder and then click OK. Now let's take a look at opening files. To open files, you can click on the open icon in the ribbon. You can also use the open icon in the quick access toolbar. And as it explains in the tooltip, Control O is the keyboard shortcut for executing the same command. Let's click open. And in my working directory, I have a bunch of files. There is a preview button in here that allows you to see what that object is, and you can resize the window. Later on, we'll take a look at zooming in and zooming out. What's nice about the preview is that you can rotate the model and zoom in to make sure that you're opening up what you want to open. And I indeed want to open up this assembly, so I can click the open button, or you can double click on a file to retrieve it. Now I have the assembly open in the graphics area and the model tree. In the next video, we'll take a look at the Creo Parametric interface. Okay, let's now open up a part file. So I'll click the open button and locate the file that I want. If you happen to know part of the number, you can type in the upper right-hand corner in the selection filter, and that'll narrow down the list of choices. And if I want to open up this part, once I locate it, just double click on it. Now it's open in its own separate window. If you want to go back to the previous window, there is a Windows drop-down list, and then you can choose to go back to the assembly. Now let's open up a drawing. I'll click the open button. And there is a type drop-down list that allows you to filter based on the kind of object. I can choose drawing. There's the one drawing in here. Double click on it, and it opens on the screen. Lastly, let's take a look at moving models around on the computer screen. So I'm going to go back to the assembly. First off, let's take a look at spinning the model. So if you want to spin a model, you're going to hold down the middle mouse button and then move your mouse, and the model is rotating based on how I'm moving the mouse. And right now, it is spinning about something called the spin center. If you take a look at the center of the graphics area, there's a little symbol that is green, red, and blue. That's called the spin center. And while the spin center is displayed, that is the center of your spin. If you turn off the spin center, then the model will rotate about wherever your mouse is when you start the spin. For example, if I'm positioned out over here, hold down the middle mouse button and move the mouse, that was my center of spin. If I move my mouse over to the right and do the same thing, we're spinning about a different location. Now let's take a look at zooming in and zooming out. If you want to zoom in and zoom out, just position your mouse over the center of spin and then just roll the mouse wheel. If you don't have a mouse wheel on your mouse, then you can hold down the control key and drag the mouse forwards and backwards to zoom in and zoom out. Be aware that if you have your mouse positioned out towards the edges of the graphics area and you start to do that and move your mouse left to right instead, you can spin about an axis normal to the computer screen. So just be careful if you're using the control key and you're doing middle mouse button and going left and right instead of forwards and backwards, you'll get a different kind of spin as opposed to a zoom. And if we want to pan the model around on the computer screen, you're gonna hold down the shift key and middle mouse button. You'll notice sort of a rubber band effect where the model is following wherever my mouse is going. And as you become more familiar with manipulating models with the mouse, you'll find that you can actually get away without having to use the shift key for moving stuff around. Basically, what you'll do is if you want to move something to the left, you'll position your mouse out to the right and then zoom in and zoom out. Similarly, if I put my mouse over here and use different combinations of zoom in and zoom out, it's how I can get away with panning the model on the screen without using the shift key. This concludes lesson number 1. I hope you enjoyed this video.